go to gate 94 in Makkah in the Haram, you will see him sitting in a wheelchair. If you go to gate 94 on the left, you'll see him sitting in a wheelchair reading the Quran, and always between Maghrib and Isha reading the Quran. So if you have questions, quick questions, and then let him read, because he prefers to read. And he says that he has a house in Makkah. He says, this house is like Hira for me, just to worship Allah. I don't give my number to anybody from in this house. When he's in Jeddah, he gives his number to people in Jeddah to call him for questions and answers. And in Jeddah, he had some extra land, and that's the land that he built a masjid in it. And alhamdulillah, he's from the things that he's very strong on, or very careful with, is the rights of the mosque. And this masjid, Masjid al-Sunnah, Masjid Ansar al-Sunnah al-Muhammadiyya, he called it, according to the Ansar al-Sunnah of Egypt, which nowadays has gone astray. Before it used to be better than now. Now they follow the path of Sayyid Qutb and so on, as the Sheikh mentioned to us. But anyway, he said that this masjid, every time in this masjid, he's very careful. No flyers come in, except that he sees them. Because he doesn't want any... And usually you have around Jeddah, people go around, speakers, they go around to different masajid giving talks. Just don't let anybody come unless we know who he is, because this is deen, and we should be careful whom we take our deen from, whom we take our religion from. So he's careful. Even Jum'ah, Khutbatul Jum'ah, he doesn't have, because he's afraid the Ikhwanis, they will take the masjid over. They will make a problem for him, and they will try complain to the government, and then maybe try and change the masjid to Ikhwani Muslimin Masjid. But alhamdulillah, Masjid Salafi. And the best prayer you'll pray, one of the best prayers you will pray, in terms of the khushu' and also the sunnah. And he, every time, Saturday, Sunday, because Saturday is the first day of the week there, Saturday, Sunday, Tuesday and Wednesday, he will be teaching. This was before, but nowadays with his old age, he only comes Saturday and Sunday. Saturday and Sunday. And alhamdulillah, I left him last year, towards the end of last summer, towards the beginning of last summer, and he was teaching Umdat al-Ahkam. He just finished Kitab al-Tahara, and to be honest with you, it was difficult to leave the Sheikh, because we moved to Medina. So, but we managed to see him regularly in this time, and alhamdulillah, Sheikh Hafidhullah is very beneficial. And one time we went to see Sheikh Rabi' Hafidhullah. We said to him, we spoke to him about Sheikh Al-Banna, that he's teaching this book and he's teaching that book and he's teaching, and he loves Bukhari and Muslim. Teaching books, he loves to teach the text, the ahadith, to go through the ahadith. Like if you say to him, what about this book and this, he says Bukhari and Muslim. Bukhari, even if you go through the chapter headings of Bukhari, it's sufficient for you. There's knowledge there. So we said to Sheikh Rabi' Hafidhullah, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Banna is teaching this book and then that book and then this book and then. He said, this man, 60 years upon Salafiyya. If you just learn his manners, yakfik, is sufficient for you. His manners is beautiful manners, mashallah. And manners is heavy. Akhlaq is heavy on the Day of Judgment. So it's upon all of us to, have good manners. Akhlaq al-aliyah. First and foremost, such that the people will follow the path of the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And just before I finish, inshallah,